Stassi, would you like to give people a brief update on where we are on the historic car project?
Thank you, John. On the historic car project, for those of you that aren't familiar with it, just to recap, what this is the four-car rehabilitation of the 1880s wooden coaches, Paycar F, and RPO 65. From my perspective, it's one of the more interesting projects that's happening in the historic preservation industry for railroading and heritage rail. And this, coupled with locomotive 168's impending rehabilitation to service, would be of great asset to this railroad in terms of being able to depict a living history era that's a little bit earlier than what we're doing currently. Our current project is the Jackson and Sharp built car 292. It was built in 1881. The project began in earnest in late November, and our talented woodworkers, Zell Olson and Dan Frazier, have been working very hard to make sure that this project happens on time. The accomplishments to this point, we have assessed all the structural components of the car and found it to be in incredibly favorable condition. Sidewalls have been disassembled and end walls have been disassembled to do the evaluation on the structural framing as well as the frame of the car. And as I said before, we have found that to be in extremely good condition. Interior paint stripping has been completed at this time, and it turns out that the interior of this car is actually very different than we originally thought it to be. The car actually has alternating bands of black walnut and white oak. And if any of you find yourself in Antonito to come take a look at it, it's well worth a look. It's one of the most stunning coaches that I've actually been in myself. So we have found out that yes, this is very different than what we thought the car to be. And at this time, we have made all the window frames that are necessary and rehabilitated a few of the old ones that were in condition that could be reused in service. The inter-window panels have been made, the inner sashes have been made, all exterior side materials are on hand, the vertical studs, panel rail, belt rail, etc. have been replaced, and new tongue and groove poplar siding is going up for the first time since 1886 on the car when it was rehabilitated at that time. Some additional framework was added to it. New drip rail has been installed, leather facing on the nailing surfaces has been installed. We have had all our work to date approved by the historic preservation officer that's assigned to our project, as this project is being run as part of the State Historic Fund. And they have witnessed the work that we are doing, our documentation, and we are approved as everything is being conducted in terms of the Secretary for Interior Standards of Rehabilitation. We have been approved to complete the project at this time. Not only has the SHF viewed our current work favorably, but they have also invited us to apply for a grant for the next car, which is car 256, which is a Barney and Smith car from about the same era. And they have asked us to provide our grant application early so that they can comment on it and be sure that we can get funding so we can continue this very important and very significant project here at the Goombers and Toltec. At this time, we are under budget and we are on time for a completion about a year from now for car 292. And then at that point, well, thank you. And at that point, hopefully, we will have the funding in hand so that we can continue right into car 256. And all going well, in about 5 years, hopefully, we can have our entire four-car historic train set ready for service and hopefully locomotive 168 to pull it with. So at this time, I'd like to open it up for questions.
Let me remind you, Stassi, that the Friends are doing the fifth car in Colorado Springs, which is a tourist sleeper. And if you haven't any idea what that means, ask Stassi. But a very, very rustic form of transportation rather than the elegance that I think Pullman sleeper evokes. In any event, the real intent of this whole program is five cars, not just the four we're doing ourselves. And so I want to make sure that the Friends are noted for their very excellent work on 470, the tourist sleeper.
Thank you, Dan, for bringing that up. Yes, I would be remiss, most certainly, to not say that we have had great conversations with John Engs and other members of the Friends on their project, and we have visited their wonderful work in Colorado Springs, and you know, we would like to continue to thank them for their wonderful work on that car, which is going to add a whole nother level of interest to the historic train set. So thank you.
Thank you. Okay, I think in the interest of time, let's move ahead then to
the financial
marketing report.
No, the financial.
Oh, the financial report.
Financial report. Yeah.
George.